They have a big mouth and they can smoke screen everything. When they know the money is not going to be used for the purpose it is intended for, when they know it's going to fill a private pocket, when they know it's not going to be serviced anytime in the future, it's one way of maintaining the crippled and disabling African societies. Eritrea is not poor. Why? We have a very long experience. We have survived a very long war with very limited resources. We are a very small population. We had to face superpowers, and we were able to make it. That is a lesson for the people of this country. It's a fact of life. If you depend for your living on someone else, you better not live. And you cannot make it if you are relying on anyone else. We do not want to rely on any external force, because that would be the end of the story. If you ask me, I don't want anyone to pity the situation in Africa. If you pity, it's shedding tears and full stop. What does that mean? What does that contribute to any change? I think we need to have the stamina and say, we have failed. We have failed because of our own wrong doing. It's up to every African to think that what we live in today has been a result of wrongdoings for so many decades. Being a politician or an official of government and being corrupt and rich were synonymous in Africa. It's very phenomenal. It's not one or two cases. It's everywhere in Africa. You can find luxurious living environments for a handful of corrupt officials who hypocritically try to portray themselves as champions of independence, champions of democracy, when in reality they're creating a situation very explosive for the future.
Africa, we Africa, Africa.